Welcome back. In the previous episode, we imported our camera geometry and went over some basic UI. In this episode, we'll set up some selection groups for our camera. Selection groups are going to allow us to identify different parts of the geometry which require different kinds of textures. If we take a look at the reference pictures, you can probably identify some areas where it would really benefit us if we could only select those for painting onto. For example, we might only want to be able to paint onto the lens ring and the small lens adjusters. We can actually create a selection group just for those parts of the geometry, so we can just select those for painting. Another example is, if you look at a higher contrast image, parts of the camera have this stucco effect, and other areas like the sticker and frame around the camera do not. Selection groups are really going to help us isolate those parts. To access your selection groups, you can open the selection groups palette. Like the other palettes, you can click and drag this to dock it anywhere you like in the UI. The selection group available here came from the original imported file, since we selected the Create from Face Groups option. With future projects, you might have the geometry files containing face sets, which you can convert to selection groups in Mari. Remember to click the Create from Face Groups option during project setup to import your face groups. If you click the selection group, make sure the Select tool is activated with the S key, and select selection group at the bottom of the palette. You can see the entire geometry is selected with this group. You also have the option to hide and unhide specific selection groups, which might be useful if geometry is obstructing other geometry you need to paint on. So let's create our first selection group. Looking at our reference picture, I noticed that the glass lens itself is nothing like anything else on our object, so it might be a good idea to create a group for that. Make sure the Select tool is activated, and in the Selection menu, we're going to use Face Mode, which gives us the ability to select specific faces or polygons on the geometry. Along the top of the UI is a series of context-sensitive options. These will change depending on what tool we have selected. Since we have the Select tool active, we can see some options and modes for our tool. We want to use front-facing for now, so we only select what is currently facing the camera. Through is going to select every polygon within your selection, even if it's not currently visible to the camera. Activate Smart Selection, and this will select faces on the mesh depending on what type we have selected here. If you have Connectedness Mesh selected, it will select the areas on the model connected in 3D view. If you have Connectedness UV selected, it will select the areas on the model connected in UV space. For now, Connectedness Mesh will do the trick for the lens. Click on one of the lenses in the viewport, hold Shift, and click on the other lens. In our Selection Groups palette, click the Create Selection Group button and provide a name that will make sense to you. Now you can see that once you select the group, it highlights the lens polygons only. This means we can hide and unhide those specific polys, and also paint exclusively on them. Let's set up another group, and we'll make use of the rectangle and lasso selection tools, so you can get a bit more familiar with being able to select and deselect specific faces in Mari. We'll create a selection group for this front stucco panel, so when it comes to texturing the stucco effect, we can isolate it to these polygons only. With the Select tool and Smart Selection activated, change the type to Connectedness UV, then click on the front panel. Since this panel is split off from the rest in UV space, it should only select that. We have some additional polygons along the edges that we don't really want though, because they don't have the stucco effect, so let's remove them. We only want this section here selected. Head over to the Ortho UV Viewport tab. This displays our orthographic view and UV view on a single layout. Along the top toolbar, activate Rectangle Selection Mode. Holding down the Control key is going to remove polys from our current selection if we click on them. So with Control held down, click and drag a rectangle marquee to remove all the polygons we don't want. You can zoom in to deselect any polys that weren't caught by the rectangle marquee. Polys can get missed by the selection marquee when the polygon faces are smaller than the pixel on the screen. Make use of the UV tab along the top if you need to select small or difficult polygons. Activate the lasso selection to deselect or reselect any awkward to reach polygons. If you do need to reselect any polys, hold the shift key. The cursor changes to display whether the next selection you make adds or removes from the current selection. We also need to remove the central circle section. Make use of the lasso tool to deselect this entire circular area. You should end up with a selection that looks like this. Click the Create Selection Group button and provide a name for this new selection group. Use the selection tools we've just learned to create these remaining selection groups. You can create selection groups at any time throughout your painting process, but to start painting, these groups will be really helpful. We can actually inform Mari using the painting settings to isolate our painting to only selected polygons. In the next video, we'll start painting base colours onto our camera using the selection groups we just created. See you then!